It was a very bizarre dream, one of the strangest. We were somehow in this auditorium, but then it turned into a factory. I was looking on the floor, and there was red everywhere, and so it was like there was blood everywhere. And somehow it switched to the past, and I saw all these people moving this factory equipment out of that space that they had been working in, and that was why the blood was there. But then it switched somehow to the future again, and I was one of the two people that this man was doing this very strange factory work where there was all these different machines, and each machine had a different thing that they put into it. Like, one machine fed cats into it, and the cats got all ground up, and then the blood was pouring out. And then another machine fed babies into it. And then it was, I can't remember what else was being fed in, but, and why he was doing this, but it was quite organized and systematic. And then the factory was big, with tubing going everywhere, and there was clanking noises here, and then there was blood spurting out here, and it was running along the ground. And I was trying to get out. I didn't want him to know I was going to leave, because if I left, he would know that I would have to be killed, because I knew too much information about the organization and about what they were doing. So I had to leave out in this taxi. And then I got away from him. I took this other guy with me. And we were trying to get away. And trying to get away. Yeah. And where are we? Thank you. some strange country. There was jungle and everything. We were moving along in a car, very slowly. And we passed by a bunch of people walking, all chained up. And I said to whoever was there, they look like, look at their slaves. Most people were black. They were all dirty. Mud all over them. And towards the back, there started to be all these white faces. 22-year-old North American looking kids. And their hands were chained one to the other. And then at the far back, there was a girl. A blonde girl. The look on her face was just dead. Like she wasn't there. She was just vacant. And somehow we were in the army commander's headquarters or something. I think he was the leader of the area. And some guy comes in taking some big guy. He's hanging on to one of the kids that was in the lineup. And he brings him in, sort of dragging him, saying he decided he'd run for it, but I caught him. And you could see that one of the kid's feet, his foot was, it's all swollen up. His toes were all big and purple. He's crying and looking at us, saying, please help me, please help me. And the leader goes, okay, you know what to do with runners. You can't run with only one leg. Take him and cut off his leg. Take him and cut off that bad foot. The kid would start screaming. The guy was dragging him away. I felt terrified. Frozen. I was scared. And then the colonel says to us, we don't really cut it off. We just scare the shit out of them. We need people with 2 feet. And then everything shifts. There's a bunch of us checking into the hotel.
Thank you. Hi,
I'm walking along a sandy beach. I see a little house. It's perched up on stilts about 10 feet in the air. It's just a small wooden shack. There's no other houses around. Somehow, I know it's my house, and I've had it for years, but I forgot that I owned it. I've forgotten all about it. And the sand is getting in my eyes, and there's pieces of grass sticking out of the sand dunes. And there's weird things like chairs and TV sets that are half covered in sand, and tables, lots of garbage. And the crows are there eating the garbage. When I get closer to the house, I see there's a wooden ladder up into it. So I climb it and raise the trapdoor. And it's dark. But I see there's a little kitchen. It's all weathered wood. But there's cupboards and then a bed. On the bed, there's a leg sticking out from under the covers. So I go over to the bed, and I slowly pull back the sheet to see who's sleeping there. But I jump back because it's just a leg. There's no body, with a running shoe and a sock on it. I try to scream. I want to wake up, but I can't scream and I can't move. I know something terrible is going to happen. ghost did fly through the sky. I hear their cries, strange lullaby. Close your eyes and try to sleep. They wait for me in the middle of the night. It's hard to believe it now, but I know it's gonna work out right. Dreams will come, and when they're done, it won't be long until the dawn. So close your eyes and try to sleep. Strange noises always make it difficult to sleep. The dogs are barking and it echoes down the street. I hear their cries from far and wide, echo through the sky, strange lullaby. Crows did fly. Close your eyes and try to. Close your eyes and try to sleep. Close your eyes.